Luke chapter 8 was 43 to 46. And a woman having an issue of blood for 12 years spent all her living upon physicians, and none of them could heal her, came from behind Jesus and touched the hem of his garment, and immediately her issue of blood stopped. Jesus said, "Who touched me?" "Someone hath touched me, and virtue hath gone out of me." My message to you today is how to touch Jesus. Here thousands of people are touching Jesus in the crowd, and Jesus says, "Someone has touched me." In fact, all these people are touching Jesus because of their need. They want a miracle. They want a healing. They want a touch from God. They also came for a blessing. But Jesus is saying, only one person has touched me. Only this woman could touch Jesus. I want to ask you one question. What was so special about her touch? This woman, 12 years, she had an issue of blood. And she was bleeding for 12 years. And as she was bleeding, she was seeking for Jesus. Bleeding and seeking at the same time. All her money was gone. All her blood was lost. Troubles were there. And she was struggling but still seeking for Jesus. It is easy to go to church when all is well. It is easy to go to a holy place like a picnic. But when there's no food at home, when there's no job, it is difficult to seek for God. I know of people who come fasting and prayer. They come and fast for even half a day because at home there will be biryani. But when you have no food at home, when you have no money, to fast is very hard. See this woman struggling, bleeding, but still seeking. And that is what touched Jesus. And the devil knows that when troubles come, we leave God and go away. And that is why he keeps giving struggles in our life. If you can seek God in the midst of your troubles, I tell you, that is what will touch the Lord Jesus. And because of this, you know what happened? Jesus stopped and gave her the first priority, because she came to him seeking while bleeding. Amen. Today I want to tell you, maybe you're looking for a miracle. Maybe you're looking for a blessing. Maybe you're looking for a breakthrough in your life. Seek him in the midst of your struggles. And I assure you that the Lord will be touched. Number 2, verse 45, the crowd was too much. A big crowd. There were a lot of barriers that she faced. First is the crowd. The crowd was desperately following Jesus. The religion which said that she's unclean and she cannot come to a holy God. The barrier of sickness and weakness where she couldn't even walk. But you know what she did? She pushed aside every barrier, the people. She pushed them, each one aside, and she came and touched the hem of his garment. Amen. We people give a lot of excuses to come to Jesus. But this woman, in order to come closer to Jesus, she pushed aside every barrier, pushed aside the religious people, pushed aside the crowds of people, and somehow came closer to Jesus. I want to tell you today, unless you come close to Jesus, you cannot touch him. In order to touch the Lord Jesus, you need to come closer to him. You see, if you want to come and touch me now, you've got to come close. And that's why this woman, breaking all barriers. I do not know what the barrier is in your life today. Maybe the barrier is a habit which is preventing you from coming close to Jesus. It is time to push every barrier aside and say, "I want to come closer to my Jesus." Your friends may be a barrier. Your habits may be a barrier. Your weakness may be a barrier. Your denomination may be a barrier. Your religion may be a barrier. Your bad thoughts may be a barrier. But whatever the barrier is, push it aside like this woman and say, I want to get closer to my Jesus. If your mobile phone is a barrier, break it. But get closer to Jesus. Only then you can touch the Master. Yes, the second decision we need to take, if you want to touch Jesus and receive your miracle, you need to get closer to Him. Pushing all the barriers aside, come closer to Jesus. Amen. Number three, in Mark chapter 5 verse 26, she went to many doctors, physicians, and they could not heal her. And it says in verse number 28, she heard about Jesus and she believed that if only she could touch the hem of His garment, she would be made whole. Listen carefully, my dear friends. This woman lost her money. She lost her health. She lost her home. She lost her relatives. She lost her friends. She even lost her church. And after losing everything, there was nothing left in her. But one thing she did not lose, and that she held on to, was a faith that if I only touch the hem of His garment. She lost everything, but held on to the faith in Jesus. And that is what touched my Jesus. Some of us pray and we don't get an instant miracle and we leave the Lord immediately. But this woman, 12 years of loss. She lost her blood. She lost everything. But she held on to her faith in Jesus. And Bible says in verse 29, immediately she was healed. Immediately. What 12 years could not do. Immediately. And Jesus looked at her and said, your faith has saved you. You know why? She didn't have 1 rupee left with her. She didn't have little blood also. Everything was over. But because she held on to that faith, I tell you, the Lord says, your faith has saved you. Today, maybe you have lost everything. Maybe you've lost your money. Maybe you've lost your health. Maybe you lost your hope. Maybe you lost your vision. I've come to tell you, do not lose your faith in Jesus. Hold on to Jesus, because He will do a miracle for you. It may take 12 years, it may take 30 years. But hold on to your faith and don't lose your faith. Many of you are going through struggles and you're seeking to touch Jesus. I want to tell you, hold on to your faith that if you only come close to Jesus, He will give you a miracle. Amen. How many of you want to touch Jesus today? Point number one, seek Him while you're struggling. See this woman bleeding, yet seeking. Push every barrier aside in order to come closer to Jesus. And number three, though she lost everything, she held on to her faith. Hold on to your faith in Jesus, and He will save you. God bless you.